course. What's on your mind?
Thank you.
This isn't a formal meeting. I simply want to clear the air. I think we may have gotten off on the wrong foot when we first met, and I feel like I owe you an apology. Expecting you to embrace the standards of the Brotherhood without having a history with us was unfair. And given that you've adjusted so well to our beliefs, I don't think I needed to push so hard.
I'm betting it hurt to say that.
A little bit, yes. When I was an initiate, my sponsor was Paladin Krieg, toughest squad leader I ever served with.
He was a model soldier, embodying the values every trainee was striving to achieve. Fiercely loyal, secure in his beliefs, and brave to a fault. From the moment I was assigned to his squad, I was singled out. It felt like he was pushing me harder than the rest of the team. I fought by his side for years, and we had some seriously close calls. But he never explained to me why I was treated that way.
Did you ever ask him why?
I'd considered it. But unfortunately, I never had the chance. After I was promoted to Paladin, and I'd moved on to my own squad, I received word that Krieg was killed at Adams Air Force Base. The news was like being kicked in the stomach. I mean, I'd lost some of my brothers and sisters before, but his death, well, it really got to me. It's taken me a long time to realize it. But the reason Krieg was so tough on me is the same reason I'm so tough on you. It's because I believe in you. And I don't want to see any of your potential go to waste.
What happened at Adams Air Force Base?
Back in the Capital Wasteland, the Brotherhood was at war with a traitorous group of rebels who called themselves the Enclave. They maintained a mobile command post at the remains of Adams Air Force Base, just outside of Washington, D.C. The Brotherhood spearheaded an assault on the command post, which was ultimately successful, but costly. Quite a few soldiers died in that battle, and Paladin Krieg was among them. He made his mark on history, and whether you choose to believe it or not, you have the potential to do the same.
I'm flattered that you have so much faith in me.
You've earned that faith by your own hand. Well, I've said what I had to say, and I hope that it meant something to you. I trust you'll keep this in confidence, of course. Some of that information was of a personal nature, and, well, I'd like to keep it that way.
Hey.
What do you want?
Your thoughts?
With all these planes that were blown across the airport, it's amazing the tower survived.
Your thoughts?
Remember, we're out here representing the Brotherhood. Let's make them proud.
Just wanted to check in, see how you feel things are going between us.
I'm not sure right now. Perhaps you should ask me that later.
Your thoughts?
There's Brotherhood, then there's everything else. Nothing in between.
Your thoughts?
It's getting late. Should we bivouac out here, or find a place to stay?
Didn't have anything else.
Affirmative.
Attention. My Captain Kate is in the sick bay below decks.
Hey, wait there.
Want?
Now that you've familiarized yourself with the Prigman's crew, are you ready for your next assignment, sister?
assignment are we talking about?
The kind of assignment where all of the training you've done finally begins to pay off. Let's get right to it then, shall we? Take a look over there. That's Fort Strong, and it's infested with super mutants. Having those aberrations of nature close enough to smell is making me sick to my stomach. To make matters worse, they're sitting on top of a massive stockpile of Fat Man shells we could use in our campaign. I want you to head over there, wipe out everything that moves, and secure that stockpile. Understood?
Super mutants? I thought the enemy was the Institute.
Super mutants are no better than Sentinels. They're a reminder of man's folly when it comes to harnessing technology. Whether it's using biochemistry to manipulate genes, or trying to create life from a bunch of circuits. It's the wrong path for science. As members of the Brotherhood, it's our sworn duty to exterminate these abominations in every form. So, can I count on you to get the job done?
What do these shells do?
The Fat Man launcher is an essential part of the Brotherhood arsenal. It's a miniature nuclear payload in a man-portable format. A squad of troops armed with one of these is virtually unstoppable. If you ever have the pleasure of firing one of them, allow me to give you a word of advice. Don't fire one of them in close quarters. There won't be enough of you to bury in a shoebox. That enough to go on?
Off the record? That's not like you, Dance.
Which is why this is going to be difficult to say. So I'd appreciate it if you bear with me.
When you were first placed under my sponsorship, I had some serious reservations about it. Despite all that, this has turned out to be a rewarding experience for both of us. At this point, honestly, I don't feel like there's anything else I could teach you about being a Brotherhood soldier that you don't already know. It's apparent from your attitude and your actions that you intend to keep those ideals close to your heart.
You're beating around the bush. Is there something you're trying to tell me?
Is it that obvious? I've never been very good at these things. Let me start at the beginning.
I grew up alone in the Capital Wasteland. Spent most of my childhood picking through the ruins and selling scrap. When I was a bit older and had a few caps to my name, I moved into Rivet City and opened a junk stand.
While I was there, I met a guy named Cutler. We got along pretty well. Watched each other's backs and kept each other out of trouble.
When the Brotherhood came through on a recruiting run, we felt like it was a way out of our nowhere lives. So we joined up.
Rivet City? Must be post-war, because I've never heard of it.
You're right. It was a settlement, built inside the remains of a beached aircraft carrier. One of the safest places to live in the Capital Wasteland, until the Brotherhood arrived. It was the perfect location for me to try my hand at being a merchant.
I didn't expect your entire life story. I hope there's a point?
I'm getting to it, if you'll let me finish. Anyway, about a year after we were posted to the Pridwin, Cutler vanished on a scouting op. It took some convincing, but I was able to persuade my CO to let me assemble a squad and search for him. It took almost 3 weeks, but we tracked his team down to a super mutant hive. Those wretched abominations had slaughtered everyone but Cutler. He should have been so lucky. The mutant bastards used their FEV to change him into one of their own kind. He wasn't Cutler anymore. It was my duty to put him down.
Are you sure there wasn't anything you could do to change him back?
The FEV effect is irreversible. There was nothing anyone could do.
You did what the Brotherhood taught you.
Then you understand why it had to be done. Ever since Cutler died, I've seen other soldiers come and go. Some were brave, some were honest. Hell, some were even downright heroic. But I'd never consider any of them to be a good friend. A friend like Cutler was. Until now. It's a good feeling, but it frightens me all the same. Having a bond with someone, then losing them. It changes you. I don't want to go through that again.
It'll never come to that. I promise.
Even though I'm well aware that you have no control over it, I appreciate the sentiment. I just thought you deserved to know how I felt. If you feel that I've overstepped my bounds, I completely understand.
Whatever the case may be, I appreciate the fact that you took the time to listen. Is something amiss?
How do you feel about our relationship?
You're one hell of a soldier, and I'm proud to call you my friend.
Your thoughts?
I have to admit, I'm very impressed. You're quite a soldier.
Your thoughts?
People in the Brotherhood are looking up to you. Keep it up, soldier.
Your thoughts?
There's a wealth of technology just waiting to be discovered out here.
Just wanted to check in, see how you feel things are going between us.
I wouldn't want to smash super mutant skulls with anyone else.
Your thoughts?
You're more than worthy to wear our uniform. Be proud.
Your thoughts?
Thanks to you, we're making a difference out here.
What are your thoughts on our relationship?
You've earned my respect, soldier. I hope that means something to you.
That was all.
Not a problem.
Hey.
Where do you want me?
Feel like trading some equipment? Your step. There's quite a bit of debris here.
Getting hungry. No green stuff here. This buckethead would show up, I'd rip his legs clean off.
This area seems to be in disarray. I wonder if this is recent. Thank you.
Brotherhood rose from the ashes of the U.S. military, you know. Hoarding that garbage, you're going to slow us down. Vigilant. This place may appear abandoned, but that doesn't mean we should drop our guard.
What's up?
All right.
Here.
Affirmative.
What's up?
What do you want?
Someone there? I hear something, huh? What's that?
Thank you. Look at this place.
You must hate these mutants as much as I do.
I was just doing what Elder Maxon asked. No more, no less.
Well, it's good to see you dealt with them the Brotherhood way. These monstrosities are just another example of man blindly taking a step forward, only to wind up stumbling two steps back. I've been fighting for years, trying to put a stop to this mess. Synths would do to us if they ever got the upper hand. It would be Armageddon repeated, and maybe the end of everything that we hold dear. Look, I don't mean to bore you with my rhetoric. I just want you to understand how important these missions are.
How could synths bring about our destruction?
If the synths reached the point where they outnumbered mankind, how long would it take for them to decide we were no longer necessary? They certainly possess the capability to make more of their own kind, so we'd become expendable. And with Institute technology on their side, nothing could stop them, not even the Brotherhood. It's a nightmare scenario almost too terrible to contemplate. Anyway, that's enough of that.
What's important here is that you got the job done and secured these warheads. You should head back up to the Pridwin and talk to Maxon. I'm sure he'll want to debrief you as soon as possible. Dismissed.
I think you should stay on point. Ready to continue our mission, soldier?
That depends. How are you feeling?
I'm locked and loaded and ready to take on the enemy. When you're ready to go, I'm right behind you.
Not now.
No problem. Let me know when you're ready.
Paladin.
Ready to continue our mission, soldier?
Not now.
No problem. Let me know when you're ready.
turbines at 87% efficiency.
You'll get used to sleeping comfortably underneath massive containers of highly flammable gas.
The last person that disobeyed Captain
Paladin Dance
ended up scraping.
Ready to continue
off
our mission, soldier?
From the outside.
Ready.
Roger that.
Outstanding work at Fort Strong, soldier.
So, what happens at Fort Strong now?
Paladin Dance is supervising the transfer of the Fat Man warheads to the Prudwin. They'll provide quite an edge to our arsenal. I've also ordered a detachment to occupy the location and use it as a staging area to protect the eastern side of the airport. All in all, you handed us quite a valuable location.
Too bad it wasn't the Institute.
Not to worry, Knight. You'll be dealing with them sooner than you think. In order to bring the Institute to its knees, we need to use every weapon at our disposal. I try to supply my soldiers with the best. That's why I'm giving you these. Signal grenades can call a vertibird to your location when you need aerial transport. Simply throw one to the ground, and the vertibird will hone in on the unique electromagnetic smoke it emits. Once you're aboard, use the map on your pitboy to interface with the pilot's navigation system, so he'll be able to take you wherever you need.
Where can I get more signal grenades?
I'd use the supply I gave you sparingly. These devices are far more complex than a standard smoke grenade. Should you need more, you should acquire them from Proctor Teagan.
The best weapon for survival out here is a pocket full of caps.
Signal grenades are usually reserved for our paladins. In your case, you should be grateful that I'm making an exception. Now, I'm sure you're aware that Fort Strong is simply the first step towards the liberation of the Commonwealth. An even greater task lies ahead. By now, I'm sure you've deduced that our arrival in the Commonwealth wasn't coincidental. We're here because of a unique energy reading recorded by Paladin Dance's recon team. According to our scribes, the reading indicated a level of technology that only the Institute could achieve. The moment this information came to light, our mission became clear. The Institute and everyone responsible for the creation of the synths must be eliminated at all costs. To accomplish this goal, we need to locate the Institute's headquarters. I've had our scribes meticulously searching the Commonwealth, but they've come up empty-handed.
Sounds like you're gonna have me crawling through the sewers now.
It could be the sewers, the transit tunnels, or maybe an old vault. We just don't have enough information right now. I want you to get out there and become our eyes and ears on the ground. You seem to have a vested interest in locating the Institute before we met, so I'm confident you'll travel in the right circles. If you discover a way in, I need you to report it to me immediately. Any questions, Knight?
Any suggestions on where I should look next?
I'd pursue your lead regarding Dr. Amari. I'm not certain if she's a crackpot or if she can genuinely assist your search, but our sources say she has some interesting technology at her disposal. Anything else, Knight?
What about those energy readings Paladin Dance's recon team detected?
Our scribes are confident that the energy readings are from Institute technology, due to the unusually high frequency. But the source is unknown. We're still detecting them on occasion. But by the time we send a team to investigate, they disappear. Just watch your step. I wouldn't be surprised if the energy reading were caused by some type of Institute weapon. Is there anything else?
Aren't there any pre-war records about the Institute that might help us?
Our records indicate that the Institute was born from the remnants of a pre-war educational facility, the Commonwealth Institute of Technology. The ruins of the facility are at the center of the city, but we've already searched them thoroughly. The location appears to have been abandoned long ago. So it appears that the trail ends there. Anything else, Knight?
Not right now, Elder.
Very well, then. Dismissed.
Sir.
Questions, Knight?
Not right now, Elder.
Very well, then. Dismissed.
Superstructure integrity, green. Hull plating stable.
Pridwin is a magnificent ship, and we're lucky to have her in our arsenal.
Anything useful on him?